Hey guys, Nerd King 101 here, and today we're doing something different. Today we are going to be talking about the Marvel Cinematic Universe. I know I try to stick to anime content, but every once in a while I like to put out something a little bit different. So today we are going to be talking about some things that need to happen in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Now, first of all, not all of these are my ideas. Some of these things have been thrown around in the comic book community already, but I do want to talk about the things I want to happen and some of the things I would do with these ideas. So the first one is somewhat surprising, something not too many have talked about, but it's been thrown around, is Spider-Man needs to go to Wakanda. A nice vacation story with Spider-Man in Wakanda teaming up with the Black Panther would be amazing. Because something I'm going to talk about a lot with this list and with this discussion is that Spider-Man's entire thing is team-ups. In fact, I believe there was a series of books that was released at one point that was literally just called Marvel Team-Ups. However, it was really just Spider-Man teaming up with everybody in the Marvel Universe, because that's kind of what Spider-Man does. He teams up with all these other characters, but he isn't really part of one big group. Yes, he has been an Avenger at different points in time, but most of the time, like 80-90% of it, he's a solo hero. So he does have the chance to team up with basically anyone, because he doesn't have, like, allegiances to any one group. Just because Avengers vs. X-Men happens, doesn't mean Spider-Man can't team up with the Avengers and the X-Men, because he has no issue with either of them. That's what's great about Spider-Man. He can team up with basically anybody. And somebody he typically teamed up with in the comics is Deadpool, because they're very similar characters. However, they're also very different. Deadpool kills people. He makes very inappropriate jokes, he's angry, he does bad things. Spider-Man, of course, like, no killing. Like, with great power, great responsibility, morality, goodness. And Deadpool, like, I just want to kill people, like, have sex with hot girls, and be awesome. And that's Deadpool's thing, and Spider-Man got his thing. And they had this, like, bromance relationship. There's a comic where they go on, like, a double date with these, like, super-powered heroes. There's so much potential for Spider-Man team-ups. Another one that would be great would be Spider-Man and Doctor Strange. I would like that. Also, obviously, when the Fantastic Four introduced, he has to cross over with the Fantastic Four. The history of the Fantastic Four and Spider-Man is very tied together. Spider-Man and the Fantastic Four have a lot going on in the comics. They have a lot of history. And it would be a total waste not to milk that team up dry. It would be more of a waste than Deadpool, Black Panther. He gotta team up with the Fantastic Four. He absolutely has to. And in general, it's safe to say that there's never been a Spider-Man-Deadpool team up that was boring. And while I don't think it would be a major part of the MCU's deeper story, I do think a Spider-Man-Deadpool team-up would be really fun to watch. You would obviously have to tone down Deadpool's R-rated personality to something more PG-13 friendly, but that's okay, because Deadpool breaks the fourth wall. Deadpool can make fun of Disney for making Marvel do it in the movie, and it can be a really funny gag. He can be like, oh, stupid Disney not letting me say the F word more than once because it's a PG-13 movie. This is so stupid. Beep, 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 beep. And you can, like, beep out all the F words. And you can have a lot of fun with it if you're just creative. You can make it work. I promise you. Deadpool has appeared in some cartoons before. And granted, a cartoon, like a Disney Marvel cartoon, because of how kid-friendly those are, he's not very good in those. But even in those, he manages to get a chuckle out of me and kind of stay in character. But I'm sure in a Marvel movie where he's allowed to, like, stab people and still, where he's, as long as he's allowed to kill people, I think we're good. As long as he's allowed to be very violent and have that personality but just toned down, we're good. I think it would work just fine. Now, why don't we talk about the next thing that needs to happen? I don't have anything big or major for this because I'm not the biggest fan of the runs. But you need to have some good X-Men movies. And I'm not saying the X-Men movies that Fox made were bad. But I want movies that are like actual X-Men movies. I want to see them in the stupid costumes. I want to see Wolverine in his yellow and blue outfit. I want to hear the sound effect like snick when his claws pop out. I want Wolverine to be beating up and fighting people like the Hulk. In fact, something that needs to happen if we need Wolverine versus the Hulk. Because if you didn't know, Wolverine's first ever appearance in comic books was when he fought the Hulk as a villain. He appeared in a Hulk comic as a villain, and it was awesome. So they could call back to that by having them fight. Hugh Jackman has even hinted that if Marvel gets the rights to Fox's property and can do X-Men, he would consider returning, because being able to play Wolverine alongside characters like Iron Man, Hulk, Mr. Fantastic, and all the big Marvel names would be awesome. Because Wolverine is one of the X-Men that works very well with the rest of the Marvel Universe. A lot of the time, people say the X-Men shouldn't be part of the Marvel Universe because the discrimination doesn't make sense. Like, you're like, how could you like Spider-Man and call him your friendly neighborhood hero, but hate Iceman for having ice power? What's the difference? One of them was just born with them. Well, my response to that criticism of the X-Men in comics and in the movies is that racism and discrimination doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. Like, did slavery make sense? Did it make sense for the white people to enslave the black people because their skin color is different? No. It's discrimination. It's not meant to make sense. It's stupid. So I think it's very likely that they'll be in the MCU. I see no reason for them to exclude the X-Men. That would be mind-bogglingly stupid. It works in the comics really well because it feels even more real with the fact that there are other people that are just as different as them. But because they weren't born with these abilities, it's okay. But the people that are born with them and get them randomly at puberty, no, that's too far. And I'd love to see some of those stories coming to light in the MCU. In fact, what would be really interesting is if you had movies that were kind of sort of a solo / team-up movie. What I mean by that is, then you focus on Kitty Pryde. You follow her story of being approached by Professor Charles Xavier. She goes to the Xavier school for gifted youngsters, and you follow her story at the school, but she, being at the school, gets to interact with Wolverine, Cyclops, Storm, Jean Grey, because they're also there, but you're telling the story through her eyes, and then you have other characters that you could have a Cyclops solo movie where he shows up, and a Jean Grey story, and then you can tell multiple character stories in those solo movies, if that makes any sense. So basically, solo movies for different periods in X-Men history, like the original five, you could have a solo movie about a couple of them, some solo movie for them about their experiences starting at the school. And you could have a Kitty Pryde solo movie, a Jubilee solo movie. I mean, you could do so much with the X-Men. There are so many awesome characters. It would also be great to see Franklin. We'll also get to see Franklin Richards later on, which will be amazing because Franklin Richards is a great character. He's actually a member of Power Pack in the comic. He's never really used to his full potential because he's so powerful. But, you know, you could, like, have Reed build him, like, an inhibitor collar that, like, lowers his power level drastically. And then you could have him team up with, like, the Power Pack. And you can have a Power Pack movie. Or maybe instead of the Power Pack, if they're a little too young for maybe a big Marvel movie, maybe you could make him a member of the Young Avengers. That would be awesome. If he was a member of the Young Avengers. Another thing that would be awesome would be if they could find a way to make the Illuminati work. I know it's unlikely they can do it because, like, Robert Downey Jr. and Chris Evans and all of them are going to probably be leaving after Avengers 4. But maybe you could find some other big name characters. Maybe like Black Panther could do it. I don't know. But it would be nice to see some rendition of the Illuminati. And then maybe if Disney could somehow get the rights to Hulk back from Universal, like they did with Fox the rights to the X-Men and the Fantastic Four, then maybe, just maybe, we could get a two series, we could get two Hulk movies. Planet Hulk and World War Hulk. I would kill to see Planet Hulk, but I'm not. Planet Hulk would be cool. I'm not the biggest fan of Planet Hulk because I just find the Hulk pretty, he's fun with other people, but when he's on his own, I just don't really feel him very much. But Planet Hulk is a necessity to get World War Hulk, and World War Hulk would be fantastic. You could see some Iron character, probably Ironheart, I believe that's what she called. The Riri Williams character, I believe her name is. I did not really keep up with the legacy characters, I didn't really care. I wasn't really invested in comics too much at the time, and now they're kind of starting to roll back into the old characters. So I'm like, whatever, maybe you could have Ironheart in there, you could have Black Panther in there. I guess if they still want to try to introduce the Inhuman, they could introduce the Inhuman and have Black Bolt be in there. Doctor Strange can be in there easily. That actor is going to be in there for a while because he just started. He's only done two movies. That would be fun. The last thing I want is a very simple request. I want the Fantastic Four to be a family, and I want Franklin Richards to appear in the movie. Because Franklin Richards is part of the family. That's the thing. Like, you can't just do the Fantastic Four from like 16 years ago. You have to do a current Franklin Richards, because I really like Franklin. I think he's interesting. I think he has a whole new dynamic to the team, having a kid. I think when it's just a ton of adults, it's just kind of the same thing we've seen before. I think it adds something different from all the previous movies that is drastic. Because if you don't have Franklin, it's just kind of like, we did that. We did that thing that Fox did, we just did it better. But Franklin Richards could set a whole new dynamic to the movie because he's Greg Richards and Sue Storm's the son. And I'm sure you could figure out a way to roll Franklin and her daughter in very early on. I'm sure with all the cosmic mumbo jumbo and space travel and time manipulation they've introduced into the MCU, it would be easy to just wave that away somehow and get them a kid. Get a good child actor. He can join the Young Avengers, as I mentioned earlier, and also a Young Avengers movie. Like, is it too much to ask for a team in the MCU that's like a ton of teenagers or little kids kicking ass together? Is that too much to ask? Dude, I'm a big fan of those, like, children teams in comics. I think it's really cool because they're always a lot of fun. They don't have as much of drama or dark and gritty nonsense that all the other teams and heroes and solo movies do. They're just a lot of fun. I haven't read a ton of Power Pack. In fact, I think the most I ever got out of them was Renew Your Vows. But it would be nice to see more of that. The Young Avengers would be fun. Franklin Richards would be great. Their daughter would be cool to add like a brother-sister dynamic to it as well. I also really like... I can't remember her name, but I really like how their daughter wears a blue outfit with a 6 on it, and Franklin wears one with a 5, because they're like the additional 5th and 6th members, but they're not really allowed to do anything because Sue and Reed don't want them to get hurt. It would be awesome to see all these characters together. I think having Franklin and your daughter, as I said earlier, would separate them from all the other Fantastic Four movies, but overall, I just want them to be a family. Because that's what the Fantastic Four are. They're Marvel's family, and I want more of them. So that's about all I had to say on the matter. That's all I can really think of that I really want to see. Obviously, I could go into, like, events I want adapted and things they could do. But I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to go through all the good events in Marvel's history that they could do. Because that would take forever. Because Marvel has a lot of events. They have Avengers disassembled. They have House of M, they have the Phoenix Saga, they have Age of Apocalypse, Age of Ultron, Days of Future Past. And Secret Invasion, which would be awesome. But I mean, they have so many things. Obviously, I want to see these events adapted. Everybody wants to see these events adapted. They're amazing. Especially if they made them better. They can make a lot of these better. But overall, that's all I have to say. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Tell me what you want to see in the future of the Marvel Cinematic Universe in the comment section down below. Like the video if you enjoyed. And while you won't get a ton of this kind of stuff, if you do want to be alerted when the next time I talk about the MCU or maybe some DC stuff, subscribe to the channel because I do it occasionally because I do like this stuff. It's just not my specialty, so I prefer to focus on anime. Also, follow me on Twitter, which is linked in the description box down below. And above all else, guys, have a great day. This is Nerd King 101 signing out.